Hi guys and girls, welcome to our second video of our online fitness training program here at Via Verde. Today's going to be a little advanced. It's very similar to the Monday routine for those of you who have been coming to my Monday morning 9:05 a.m. class in the theater. We are going to repeat this video. I know some of you like this video and been asking for it as far as the routine. So I'm going to deliver that to you today. We're going to try to keep that same routine of exercises and time between each move and time duration for each move. So let's start with the warm-up and make sure you have your dumbbells close by, water bottle close by. And then take breaks as needed, get your water as needed, you know, just have everything close to you and nice and set up. And let's start with a little warm up. So let's stand and we're going to work on our balancing. So all you need is your chair or something to hold on to. And let's work on our little balancing, just one leg up. If you can do it without your hands, great. If not, maybe you're holding on with two hands and we're just alternating hands. Going back and forth. We're just trying to wake up our body. We're trying to wake up our neuromuscular system. And so I got a lot of working parts going on right now for this video. I got a timer set up for you when we're ready. I got a nice, beautiful microphone so you can hear me clearly. I got some music in the background, some 50s and 60s blues, something a little upbeat for this workout. If you have any music requests, please feel free whenever. Just reach out to me, ask for a specific genre, and I'll try to incorporate it on the next video for you. Part of my job description is not only being a trainer, but a DJ and a therapist as well. So any services you may need, feel free to reach out. Okay, let's switch sides. So other leg, same thing, balancing on one leg. If you can go with no hands, great. If you have to hold on, that's fine too. Again, we're just working on our neuromuscular system, trying to dial in the balance. Some of these moves are going to require your balance a little bit, so we want to just make sure that our balance is primed and ready. Our body is ready for whatever happens during the workout. So again, we're just trying to be ready, warm up the body. So this is important to do every day if you can. Just work on some balancing stuff every day in the morning. Even if it's just a minute in the morning, a minute in the afternoon, balancing on one leg for each side, it's better than nothing. So a little something is better than nothing. If you want more of a challenge, bring up the hands or not. Maybe you're doing one hand. Again, whatever you can do. And from here, let's work on a little foot speed, just stepping back, holding onto your chair. Stepping backwards, kind of like a lunge. We are going to do a lunge in our workout, and I will show you that modification for it. It is pretty challenging. Try to keep that front leg bent. That back leg is just stepping out real quick, straightening out that back leg into a nice little toe tap. We're just trying to get the heart rate up, get the blood flowing, get the muscles working. Again, priming our body for the workout. Okay, let's get some shoulder work in. So arms up, 90 degree angle in the elbows. Okay, and from here we're gonna bring it in. Hands touch inside of your elbows and forearms touch and out. And then when you come out, squeeze the shoulder blades. So your hands are in alignment with your shoulders, if possible. So you can see my elbow is right below my hand, my wrist. And that's the challenge. It's tough. I know some of you might be a little leaning forward with your forearm, but that's okay. And so we go forward, hands, forearms, touch, out to the side and squeeze. Forward, touch, out to the side and squeeze. And then here's the front view. Just going back and forth. Out and squeeze. In together, out and separate, squeeze the shoulder blades. Keep going. Should start to feel the shoulders a little bit. Upper arm, deltoids. Keep working it. Keep challenging that body. Couple reaches up now, right here. Hold out to the side and just reach. Just reach. Just straight up reach for the ceiling or the sky, whatever works for you. Maybe you're reaching a little forward because you can't quite reach up towards the ceiling. Maybe you're a little restricted with your shoulder mobility, and that's fine. Again, whatever you can do. We're just trying to get the muscles and joints warmed up. Okay, so now let's do a big arm circle. Big, big circle with one arm. Other side, big, big circle. Okay, a little swinging of the arms in front of your body, and then out to the side. Really squeezing the shoulder blades as your arms go back, crossing the arms in front of your body. You can alternate which arm comes up on top every time if you want, totally up to you. But again, just creating that range of motion and flexibility. All right, here we go. Let's get into it. First move is squats. You can use your chair, grab your dumbbells. Now I'm gonna get a timer going so you can hear everything. So timer's going, your water's close by. Music's gone, grab your weights. Let's start with one weight, very lightweight. We're gonna warm up a little bit here with just a squatting. So your feet are hip width apart. Make sure your chair is close. Right, don't miss your chair, because the goal is gonna try to touch your glutes, your bum, to the chair. So holding on the weight right in front of your chest. About 5 seconds, we're gonna get going. So from here, you're gonna squat. Push your hips back, touch the chair and stand, and we're going. Taking your time, feel the weight on your heels. Engage your core, all right? Pull the stomach muscles in. I'm gonna try to continually give you cues and reminders for your technique to help you with proper form. So you gotta feel what's happening with your body. Feel the weight on your heels. Push the hips back. If you want a side view, and I'm not using a chair for this, and you don't have to use your chair, but the challenge is trying to get your bum, your glutes, close to the chair. So imagine there's a chair behind you, and you're trying to get your glutes to the chair. Again, keeping the weight on your heels. Pushing your hips back. And time. Stop there. So now we have bent arm, lateral raise. So for this one, we need 2 dumbbells. And you're going to get your arm at a 90 degree angle. All right, so that means your forearm is parallel to the floor. All right, so for this one, we're standing nice and tall. We bring those hands forward. Forearms are pointing forward. And again, elbows are bent at a 90. And we go. Raise out to the side and down. Raise and down. And if you even want to sit for this one, you can. You just got to watch the armchair. So you have options. If you want to sit down, you can. You don't have to. I like standing for this one. Just personal preference. Keep your elbows bent at that 90 degree angle. So notice when I come out, my elbows are almost at the same height as my hands. And then down. Lift out to the side and down. Don't worry about pausing. Just raise and lower. You can pause at the bottom. Don't worry about pausing at the top. All right, so lift to shoulder height, right back down. To your shoulder height, right back down. Again, we're working the upper arm, the deltoids. And time. So now we're doing bent over rows, so we're still holding on to the 2 dumbbells. And for this one, we want to get our feet about hip width apart, bending the knees a little. And then we want to push our hips out, but we're bending forward from the waist, from the hips, and try to keep a straight back. So that's the challenge. Straight back, flat low back, shoulders retracted, there goes the bell, and we row. Now when you row, think about rowing hands to hips and down. Hands towards your hips and then down. As you lift, squeeze the shoulder blades together and down. Don't worry about pausing. I'm just demonstrating the pause at the top, but you don't have to do that pause. I just want you to emphasize those shoulder blades squeezing together as you raise the elbows up. Think about your core. Keep your tummy nice and tight. All right, you gotta pull that stomach in. Protect your lower back. Remember to breathe. Feel the weight on your heels. It's just a little bend in your knees. All right, bending forward from the waist. And time. Okay. So now we have the lunge. So for this, we use our chair to support you and help you. So let's do, you're going to stand on the right side of your chair, behind and to the right. Left hand on top of the chair, right leg forward, left leg back. I'm going to repeat that. Left hand on the chair, right leg forward, left foot back. You're to the right and a little behind your chair. Now from there, we lunge down. So you drop your, or you shift downwards towards the floor. And you can see how my knee is bent, right, at a 90. My back leg is bent. I'm almost at a 90 in both legs. Ideally, you'd want to be here, but we're not starting there yet. If you want the challenge, you can come down lower. Again, if we're learning and we're just getting at you, we're getting used to the move, right here is fine. If you don't need the chair, then don't use it. Now here's where the balance comes into play and your core is working hard. So think about your core, pull the stomach muscles in, and you're trying to hold and stay there. So we're holding that lower body position, right? Right leg forward, left leg back, heel is up on that back foot. 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1, time. So you really feel that. I felt it on the front leg. Your body weight is weight, is resistance, right? Your body weight provides resistance. So it's not always about weight and holding on to weight. So now you shift to the left side of your chair. Left leg forward, right leg back, right hand holding onto the chair. Okay, so from right here, we bend the back leg, we bend the front leg, get into position, and we're going. Again, if you don't need the chair, don't use it. Tighten up your core. Bend that front leg. Bend that back leg. Balance. Even if you're holding onto the chair, I still want you to focus on your core and keeping a good posture. Alright? So if you're holding on, totally fine. Not a problem. So hold on. Keep your tummy nice and tight. Good posture. And you should feel that front leg really working. Remember to breathe. Keep thinking about your core. Right? Tight, tight tummy. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, time. All right, so we got RDLs, the Romanian deadlifts. I don't like saying deadlifts, but we'll call, that's why we call them RDLs. Romanian deadlifts, but we're going to improvise or abbreviate and call it RDLs. So, holding on to your dumbbell behind your body with two hands. Right, so it's behind you, two hands. Hinging forward from the waist. Feet are hip-width apart. Push out your hips and bow. Bow forward. It's a hip hinge. You are hinging from your hips. Keep your shoulder blades back and together. Bow. Don't bend your knees too much. It's not a squat. Think of bowing. All right? Bow, bow, bow forward. push out your glutes as you come down. All right, so keep the weight loaded on your heels as you bend forward. Load through the heels. It should be somewhat easy to pick up your toes. I don't know if you can see my toes coming up. Your toes should feel light, right, as you come down. It should feel kind of light on the toes, right here, a little light. That means you're shifting the weight back onto your heels. And you're pushing your hips out into your hands as you come down. And that's what you want to think about doing. The goal is to get a good stretch in the back of your legs, the hamstrings, and time. Okay, the next move is a plank. So we're using the chair, elbows down or hands down. So you have options. Notice my body's straight. Heel, hips, shoulders, straight line. Okay? Or we can do planks on your elbows, which is going to be the next one. Get ready. 2, 1, and here we go. So now I'm showing you the more challenging version. Elbows down. But again, my body's straight. Heels, hips, shoulders. Straight body. Straight, straight body. Flex your core. So continue to keep that straight body. If you want a challenge, leg lift, lower. We've practiced this one before. Take your time. Don't rush this one. Slow. Slow. Easy lifts. Don't let your hips or glutes lift up higher as you raise the legs, right? So don't let your hips elevate, I should say, as you pick up your foot off the ground. Keep your hips down and just raise the foot through the heel up and down. And time. All right. That is the end of round one. It is getting warm. And we're just going to keep going for the sake of the video. Time. If you need to pause it, you can pause it on your screen. Take a little break. Now's your time to get your water. We're going back to the squats. So if you want two dumbbells, grab two dumbbells. Get yourself set up in front of your chair. We're going in 2, 1, and get after it. Squat, stand. Squat, stand. Squat, stand. Again, you don't have to go at my pace. If you need to go a little slower, that's fine. If you just want to stick with one weight, that is fine. If you don't want to use any weight, that is also fine. So, again, like I said, resistance, your body is resistance, right? Moving your body is challenging, just your body, right? You're having to move your entire body weight. Sitting down, standing up, very functional move. The move you do every day. Getting up and down from a chair, toilet, couch, dining room chair, whatever it is. Whatever seated position into a standing position you need to perform, this squat will give you the strength to do it. And time. So now we have the bent arm. Again, 90 degrees, and we go out to the side. You have about 20 seconds, so if you need to sneak in some water, recover, breathe, right? Breathe, breathe, breathe. Breathe in deep. Big exhale. All right, so you got 10 seconds. And we're going to turn sideways. I'm going to turn sideways. You can face forward. Bring the elbows up, and we go out to the side. Raise out to the side. There you go. Out to the side. Again, keeping that 90 degree angle. When you go down and when you're up, you're still trying to maintain that 90 degree angle on the way up. A little country got on here. I don't know how. This is a 50s and 60s blues radio station through Pandora, but you know, sometimes they sneak in an occasional song that's not part of the genre. But that's okay. Doesn't matter. Doesn't affect our technique. Focus on your technique. Breathe. 13 seconds. Think about that core always, no matter what. abs, abs, abs all the time. Posture's tall. And stop. Bend over row. So, hinging. We're still holding on to the dumbbells. If you need to set them down, that's okay. You have about 20 seconds. Again, quick water break if you need it. But we're just going to keep going for the sake of the video, just to keep things moving. 10 seconds now, so if you don't have your dumbbells, go ahead and grab them. Feet are hip-width apart. Strong grip. Push out your hips. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Hands pulling towards your waist. So it's almost as if you're pulling a little low towards your hip, your pockets of your pants, if you have pockets on your pants or shorts, whatever you're wearing. And if you don't, that's your gauge is your waist, right? Hips, waist, area. So it's a low pull. And again, squeezing not only your core, but your shoulder blades at the top. Squeeze at the top. Squeeze at the top. Squeeze at the top. You're almost there. Have about 15 seconds left. Keep that core nice and tight. Protect your back. 8 seconds. Keep working. Almost there. And time. Static lunge. Isometric lunge. Pretty much, it just means, fancy way of saying you're not moving. You're holding a position and you're not moving at all. So, last time we did right leg forward, this time let's do left leg forward to begin with. So you're on the left side of your chair and a little bit behind. If you don't need it, don't use the chair, that's fine. Right leg back, right hand on the chair, left leg forward, start to bend those knees and here we go. Hold it. So you're just holding that position, whatever you can do. If you need to be a little taller, that's fine, but no matter what you do, that front knee is bent. Right? We don't want to be straight leg. Bend that front leg. If you need to have that back leg a little straighter, that's fine. But work that front leg. So the weight distribution is about maybe 70% of your weight on the front leg, 30 on the back, or 75, 25. However you want to think about it. But you're loading the weight, more of your body weight on the front leg. And again, core, whether you're using the chair or not, keep those abs nice and tight. Protect your body by focusing on your core to help you with balance. Right? Tight tummy. And time. All those are tough. Even for me. Maybe because I worked out my legs yesterday, but still, those are hard whether you worked out your legs or not. Those are tough to do. You have to feel about 15 seconds. So now you're on the right side of your chair. A little bit behind and to the right. Right leg is going to be forward. You have 7 seconds. Start to get ready. Right leg forward, left leg back, left hand on top of the chair to help you with balance. And now we lunge and we hold. And so you're holding on either to the chair or you're not holding on. Totally up to you. Whatever you want. Right? Whether you're holding on or not, doesn't matter. Again, the emphasis is on that front leg. About 70% of your body weight on the front leg. Bend that front knee. And again, do what you can. Breathe. Focus on your core. Always. When I say focus on your core, you're sucking in your belly button. Sucking in your stomach. Tightening it up. All right, just by sucking in your belly button, the core becomes automatically engaged. So continue to hold. You have about 15 seconds. Almost there. 7. And time. So notice, I just touched my face, but I used my shirt, right? I didn't do it with my actual fingers. So be mindful of your hands. Don't touch your face. All right. Planks. Oh no, I'm sorry, RDLs. Grab one dumbbell, get it behind your body. We're hinging from the waist, okay? So behind your body, shoulder blades back, right? You're thinking about squeezing your shoulder blades together, right? And then from here, hip width apart, we're going, push your hips out into your hands as you bend forward from the waist. And then we stand tall again. Push out your hips as you bend forward, feel the weight on your heels, and up. Get a good stretch on the back of your legs. Really try to make sure you have a flat low back, right? You are purposefully trying to arch your lower back. You don't want to round your spine at all in any section, whether it's the lower, mostly the mid to upper rounding of the spine. You just want to avoid that. So the best way to do that is shoulders retracted, core engaged, push out your glutes before you start bending forward. So, flat low back. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. And time. Good job. All right, moving on. Planks. Now we're ready for planks. Okay. Either on your elbows or your hands. Either or. Okay? If you need to be a little higher up, that's okay too. No matter what you decide to do, your body is straight. So very beginner position would be here. Hands on top of some armrests on your chair. Body straight though, and I'm still thinking about my core. And we're going now. Let's get going. So this is pretty beginner. If you drop your hands and get lower on the seat of your chair, this becomes a little bit more challenging. So intermediate. And the most challenging would be elbows down. And an even bigger challenge to the advanced move would be a little heel raise. So again, keeping that body straight no matter which position you're holding. And even if you're up here in the beginner position, try to keep your body straight. Even if you're attempting the leg lift, that's fine. Here you can still do that. Right, but you're still trying to keep your body straight. No matter which position your arms or hands are in, you keep your body in a straight line. All right, round 3. Okay, it's our third and final round. Again, now's your time to hit the pause button if you can, or take a quick breather. Get a little water, and we're going for our last round. Squats. Five seconds. Grab your dumbbells, rack it in front of your shoulders. Weight's resting on your shoulders, and we're going. That was the bell. So if you're able to keep up and not pause at all, great. And if you do have to pause it, still good. No big deal. Not a problem. It's all relative to your strength, your ability, your skill set. It's all relative. Alright? If you're noticing you are having to pause the video quite a bit, that's alright. The more and more you do this video, the less you'll have to pause it. Alright? And if you're not pausing at all and you're able to keep up with me, then you may need to go a little heavier. Or if you're comfortable with the weight and you're comfortable right where you are, again, that's fine. Totally fine. Not a big deal. And time. Lateral raise. So it's the bent arm, 90 degree angle, raise out to the side. You have about 20 seconds. We're done with the squats. No more squats. I know we don't like them, but we need them. We need the things that challenge us, right? Because if it doesn't challenge us, it doesn't change us, which is very true in any capacity, educationally, physically. All right, here we go. Out to the side, keep that 90 degree angle at the bottom and at the top. Posture's tall, core is engaged. The tummy, nice and tight. about 22 seconds. Almost there. Keep those arms bent at a 90. That's the challenge. 3 seconds. Let's get one more in there. And time. Bent over row. Still holding on to the dumbbells, but if you need to set them down real quick, please feel free. And we have about 17 seconds left. This is your recovery time, so you focus on your breathing a little bit, okay? Feet are hip width apart. Holding on strong. Push out your hips and start to bend forward. Flat back. Okay, and from here we row. Let's go. Hands to your hips. And row. Thinking about that core. Keeping your tummy nice and tight. Keep your spine straight. About rowing to the hips. Pull that stomach in. Protect your back. About 12 seconds to go. Continue to flex your core. Protect your lower back. All right, row. Hands to hips. Hands to hips. Hands to hips. Beautiful. All right. Lunge. Static lunge. Isometric lunge. Holding lunge. However you want to think about it. Again, if you need the chair, it's in front of you. We'll start on the right side now. So right leg forward, left leg back. Use the chair with your left hand if you need it, or if you don't. Again, if you don't need it, whether you need it or not, always. Core, and we're going. Lunge, hold it, stay there. And if you're really looking to get fancy, you could grab some dumbbells and hold on. It makes it very, very challenging. I immediately regret this decision, grabbing these dumbbells, but I'm gonna stick it out for you. For those at home who are joining me with the dumbbells, I can feel my quad just firing up. As soon as I picked them up, it was immediate. 22 seconds. Again, core, right? Tummy, shoulders back a little bit. Think about those abs, all right? Keep that front leg bent. Still having that good weight distribution in the front and back leg. 30% on the back, 70% on the front. 5 seconds. Oh wow, that was tough. Okay, so now we're on the other leg. So if you need it, if you want to hold on to the chair and do one dumbbell, that's fine. So if your left leg is forward and right leg is back and the right hand is holding on, then you're loading on the left side, that left leg. All right, so you can do the same thing, but you just have one weight, which is fine. Okay, so from here, shoulders back, we're going, lunge. All right, again, if you need to put that weight down, put it down, support yourself. You can see I'm still holding on to the other dumbbell down there. For those who want to, you grab two. Or if you don't want any weight, you don't have to use any weight. Your body weight's enough, it works. You're halfway through. We're almost done with this workout routine. This is our last and final round of moves. Ten seconds. Power through that burn. It's burning. It's burning me. I feel it. It's working. I'm working with you. 3 seconds. Time. Those are good. Romanian D-lifts, RDLs. So you're grabbing one dumbbell behind your body, two hands holding onto that dumbbell, feet are about hip width apart, you have 10 seconds. As you brace that dumbbell with two hands behind you, shoulders, right? Squeeze the shoulders together. All right, there's the bell. Hinge from the waist, bow forward from the waist. Push out your hips. Think about your core. All right, nice and tight. Tummy. Keep a flat low back. Keep the stomach muscles pulled in. Flex your core. Pull the belly button in. Shoulders are back. Feel the weight on your heels. 8 seconds. Almost there. And time. All right. Last move. Planking. Last move and we are done. Finito. That's it. No mas. All right. We've got about 15 seconds. So again, hands on the arm bar if you want. Armrest of your chair. Or hands on the chair. Or elbows on the seat of your chair. Totally up to you. Again, it's all relative to your ability. Start to get ready. Get set and go. So flex your core. Keep your body nice and straight. Make sure it's straight. And if you can, a little lift. Keep that core engaged. Keep that body straight. Right? Don't rush. Take your time on this one. If you're not moving, you're just holding. And again, your body's in a straight line from heels to knees to hips to your shoulders. It's a nice straight line. As much as possible, that is. To the best of your ability. And again, you're just sucking in your stomach as much as you can. It's a great move for your core and helps support the lower back. In time, bravo. All done. Good job. Women and children, beautiful. And men. We have some men in there too. Good work. All done. Let's stretch really quick. Maybe about 5 minutes or so. Hold on to something that's a little taller than your chair. Maybe a kitchen surface or the back end of your sofa. Sofas tend to be a little taller. Or whatever you have, just something that's a little higher up so that we can grab the back foot. This is challenging. Hopefully you can do this. Depending on your needs, you may or may not be able to do this. And of course, balancing comes into play, so this kind of makes it tough, okay? So be mindful, be aware, think about your body, what you're doing, what you can and cannot do. And we're right here, we're stretching the quads. We need to stretch out the quads from the lunges that we did, because those were burning. All right, so now we do the other leg. All right, so we're stretching out the other side. So you just turn around, grab whatever surface you're holding on to, and then just pull on that foot. You're trying to bring your glute or your heel to your glute. Perfect. Okay, now we can sit down. Let's get into the figure four stretch. We've done this one before. Get that leg up. All right, you're getting that ankle on top of your thigh, a little bit above the knee, and then the ankle's kind of on the outside of your thigh as well. Your arm is assisting and pushing down on that knee. If you can, you might be a little taller or higher up with your knee and then this is all you can do, that's fine. Whatever you can handle. Or maybe this bothers you a little bit and you just, maybe you need to cross your legs. Or you're down here, crossing your legs. Again, it's all relative, whatever you can handle, whatever you can do. Let's do the other leg. So great job, guys and girls. Even though I'm not physically there with you, and we're not in each other's company, I'm there in spirit. Continue to mind your posture and think about your core. Even at home, doesn't matter. Mind your balance, be careful. You're gonna be in your home a lot more than you're used to, a lot more than you like. So just be careful, be mindful. Don't get complacent and think that everything's okay as far as not having to worry about tripping hazards or falling in your home. It's always a possibility or a danger. You've got to keep your wits about you at all times. Not just in your home, but outside, right? All right, hamstrings. Let's get a little stretch here. One hand reaching, or two. If you can get two in there, even better. All right, whatever you can grab is nice or fine. Grabbing your toes, grabbing your shin. Maybe you're a little higher up on your shin, below the knee. Wherever you grab is fine. Other side, hamstrings. Remember, it's always important to stretch. After a workout, stretch, 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 always. After a workout, get a good little stretching routine in. Even if it's just something a little light, something's better than nothing, right? Okay, shoulders, right arm out in front of you. Keep your arms straight. Come across your body, because we're doing our right arm, and cross the body to the left, and you're gonna get your hand or your other arm to pull into your chest. And this one's always funny to watch, or at least it was when we were in the theater, because the transition to the other side was always challenging for most people. But again, I'm going to try to guide you through it. Left arm out. Move it over to the right side of your body. Still straight. Now your other hand is pulling that arm into your chest. Now let's get our right arm. Touch your shoulder with your fingers on your right arm. Right shoulder, right hand, right set of fingers, five digits, touching your shoulder, the top of your arm, deltoid. Now start to bring that elbow up, and with your other arm, your other free hand, raise. And you're trying to get your arm vertical. If you're able to, you can even start to pull behind your head. So it's a big tricep and shoulder stretch. Helps with mobility too. So for some of you who struggle with bringing your arms vertical towards the ceiling, this actually helps you out. Gives you that range of motion or mobility. But if you have a prior or an existing injury, it'll just improve it a little. I mean, it depends on the extent of your injury. But it's still good to stretch, even if your range of motion is limited. Okay, left side, so left hand, left set of fingers, touch your left shoulder, left deltoid, bring the elbow up towards the ceiling, use your free hand to assist, either pushing from below or pulling from up above. And that's it. Bravo, guys and girls, beautiful job. Stay tuned for more videos. Make sure you wash your hands before you do anything else. Don't touch your face. Clean off whatever sweat or surfaces that you touch during this workout. wipe things down, take